Also new at 11, a man who likely is America's most prolific serial killer speaking exclusively with CBS 46.
Samuel Little says he killed more than 90 women nationwide. The FBI has matched 34 confessions so far. CBS 46's Brittany Edney has been corresponding with Little, and she takes us inside her conversations with a serial killer.
The inside of the envelope there.
A little TV lady.
A pet name inscribed on the envelope.
In other words, you belong to me.
Psychologist Dr. Dave Davis examines all of my conversations with a serial killer.
Playing you, isn't he?
Handwritten letters straight from Samuel Little himself.
What do you mean?
He's trying to appeal to you. He's flirting with you.
Little confessed to strangling more than 90 women since the 1970s. He described to investigators how he watched the life leave their faces as he squeezed their necks with his bare hands. This same man compliments me for being, quote, a woman of great stature and strength.
He has a charming streak to his personality, but I also suspect that he may have used this as part of his enticement.
The killer's note looks dramatic. In an elaborate script, Little wonders why I didn't respond to his last letter.
The thing is, these are the only letters I've ever received from him. The one that he's referring to, it was never delivered.
He's telling you in the letter that he's missed you. He's concerned about you. He's worried that something might have happened to you.
Concern isn't something this man has shown to many women.
He's playing you to some extent. He wants to drag this out.
I've often wondered about his blatant attempt at allurement. Quote, I would like to keep on talking to you about you and your beliefs.
He wants to keep your attention. So if he answers all your questions, that might end it or stop things.
Davis's analysis of the letters, Little is not mentally ill.
Matter of fact, the sentence structure and the content is such that I would say he's probably not mentally ill.
But adds a personality disorder is very likely. Psychologists call it the Madonna whore complex, where Little only sees women as one of two things, the virtuous good or the sinful bad. Little's targets were often prostitutes and drug addicts.
In one way, he likes women. Another way, he must really hate them.
If you've got your phone, tablet, or laptop handy, join me on CBS 46's Facebook page live, where I'll answer your questions on Samuel Little and the letters he's written to me from prison. I'm heading to our newsroom now, and we'll meet you on there. Live from the studio, Brittany Edney, CBS 46 News.